नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेवी एंड डॉक्टर अनामिका अहरवार, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक कंप्यूटर सिस्टम इंजीनियरिंग। इन दिस सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू कवर द कंप्यूटर बेस्ड सिस्टम, सिस्टम इंजीनियरिंग प्रोसेस, business process engineering and the product engineering. Now come to the computer based system. In software engineering, which as you all know about, we are applying some type of techniques or you can say methods on the software while you are developing a software, or you can say the application. So you can say that the software engineering occurs as a consequence of system engineering. Okay, this system engineering may take on two different forms depending on the application domain. I mean, what is the domain? This is very much important in on which you are working. So there are basically two types of domain in which the engineers work, like business process engineering and the product engineering. These two are the different. So in the first, business process engineering, this conducted when the context of the work focuses on a business enterprise. And if we are talking about the product engineering, this means that this conducted when the context of the work focuses on a product that is to be built. Okay. So this is from the business point of view, focuses are basically on the business, and here the focus is on the product that is to be built. Okay, so these both forms bring order to the development of computer based systems, and these both forms work to allocate a role of computer software and establish the links that tie software to other elements of a computer based system. Then come to the system. System is, you can say, a set or arrangement of things or related as to form unity or organic whole. The system is a set of facts, principles, rules, etc. to show a logical plan linking the various paths. System is a method or plan of classification of array or arrangements, and this is an established way of doing something, such as a method or procedure. Now, what is computer based system? So this may be defined as a set of arrangement of elements that are organized to accomplish some predefined goals by processing information. So the basic goal, you can say that it may be to support some business functions or to develop a product that can be sold to generate business revenues. And this makes use of system elements. And these elements constituting one system may represent one macro element of a still larger system. Here, the example is like, a factory automation system may consist of numerical control machines, robots, and data entry devices, and each can be its own system. Okay, so, or the other example, you can say at the next lower hierarchical level, a manufacturing cell is its own computer based system that may integrate other macro elements. So there is a system while working working on some product developing. So you have to work on the basis of some system, on some criteria which you plan. So on the as per we are regarding that to the this computer based system means there is a system in which you follow some rules and protocols through which you can do your task efficiently and easily. Okay, so you must have to follow that system also. And the role of the system engineer is what? It is to define the elements of a specific computer-based system in the context of the overall hierarchy of systems. Now, this computer-based systems make use of the following four system elements. And these elements combine in a variety of ways to transfer information. And these elements are the software, hardware, people and database. The first is the software. Software means what? It is computer programs, data structures and related work products that serves to affect the logical method, procedure or control that is required. The next is the hardware. Hardware means electronic devices that provides computing capability, interconnectivity devices that enable flow of work, and electromechanical devices that provide external functions. If you are talking about the other element, that is people, in this, users and operators of hardware and software comes in this category. Now, database means a large organized collection of information that is accessed via software and persists over time. So, the use of these elements are described in the following. First is the documentation. Documentation means what? It is a kind of descriptive information that portrays the use and operations of the system. And the procedures are the steps that define the specific use of each system element or the procedural context in which the system resides. Now come to the system engineering process. The system engineering process begins with the worldwide. The business or product domain is examined to ensure that the proper business or technology context can be established. Okay, so the worldwide is defined to focus on a specific domain of interest. Here, the focus is on the domain of interest. Means you focus on particular thing which you would be developed. Okay, so the whole focus on that interest also. So, within a specific domain, the need of the targeted system elements is analyzed. Okay, and then finally, the analysis, design and construction of a targeted system elements are initiated. So, at the world view level, a broad context is established. At the bottom level, you can say detailed technical activities are conducted by the relevant engineering disciplines, like software engineering. So in this context, always design a thing be considering it in its next larger context, a chair in a room in a house in an environment in a city plan. Okay, I think you got my point. Okay, so this is basically the system engineering process. Okay, so as per the thing, we consider that thing and work on that targeted system elements. And during this, we have to follow all the phases like analysis, design and constructions. Just focuses on the target system elements, right? You see here this system engineer hierarchy. This is what worldwide view. Okay, then comes to the domain view. It is specifically like if I am talking about the example, there are some applications which are business oriented, there are some applications which are object oriented, there are some applications which are entertainment oriented. Okay, so this is a kind of domain, means a particular focus on a particular topic. Okay, so this is a domain view. If further we classify this particular element, so this is the element view. If I'm talking about the education, in education, there is school level education, you know, college level education, and further we can describe the science level, arts background, commerce background. So this will be the component level. So this further and further reclassified into the things, and so that we can call it as a system engineering hierarchy. Now come to the system modeling. At each view level, this defines the process like domain classes in object-oriented terminology that serves the needs of the view under consideration. The second is that it represents the behavior of the processes and the assumptions on which the behavior is based. Next is that it explicitly defines intra-level and inter-level input that form links between entities in the model. And this represents all linkages that will enable the engineer to better understand the view. So this may result in models that call for one of the following. First is a completely automated solution, then the semi-automated solution, and the non-automated, that is manual, you can say, approach. Now there are some factors to consider when constructing a model. And what are these factors? These are, first one is assumption, then simplifications, limitations, constraints, and the preferences. In assumptions, these reduce the number of possible variations, thus enabling a model to reflect the problem in a reasonable manner. The second one is the simplifications. These enables the model to be created in a timely manner. Okay. So here the while constructing the model, this simplifies. Now come to the limitation part. In the limitation, these helps to bound the maximum and minimum values of the system. This may be useful for the system. And then the constraints. These guide the manner in which the model is created and the approach taken when the model is implemented. Now the next is the preferences. These indicates the preferred solution of all data functions and behavior, and they are driven by customer requirements. So here, optimization of some of these factors may be mutually exclusive. Okay, so these are the five factors which are considered when constructing a model. Now come to the system modeling with UML. UML is Uniform Modeling Language, and this provides diagram for analysis and design at both the system and software levels. And the examples are the use case diagram, activity diagram, class diagram, and the state diagram. Okay. So now come to the business process engineering. In this section, the business process is what? It is an engineering which defines architectures that will enable a business to use information effectively. It involves the specification of the appropriate computing architecture and the development of the software architecture for the organization's computing resources. Here I am highlighting the specification and development word, because if you specify something, that means you fully focused on that that thing. So if we are talking about the business process engineering, then it will always keep in mind that the developers develop that product which is from the customer side demands, and they totally focus on that particular product. Okay. So there are three different architectures must be analyzed and designed within the context of business objectives and goals. So the data architecture provides what? It provides a framework for the information needs of a business. Application architecture encompasses those elements of a system that transform objects within the data architecture for some business purpose, and that technology infrastructure provides the foundation for the data and application architectures. And it includes the hardware and software that are used to support the business, support the applications and data. So three different things, what are these? These are the data architecture, application architecture and the technology infrastructures. And the basis of this, analysis is important in the context of the business objectives and goals. Okay. Now next comes to the product engineering. In product engineering translates the customer's desire for a set of defined capabilities into a working product. Okay. So and this achieves the goal of by establishing a product architecture and the support infrastructure. So the product architecture components consist of what? It consists of the people, hardware, software and data. And the support infrastructure includes the technology required to tie the components together and the information to support the components. And the system component engineering happens next as a set of concurrent activities that address each of the components separately. Okay, so in this, each component takes a domain specific view but maintains communication with the other domains. And the actual activities of the engineering disciplines takes on an element view. So the analysis modeling is allocates requirements into functions, data and behavior. And in the designing modeling, this maps the analysis models into data, class, architectural interface and component design. So in product engineering, you have to focus on the requirement engineering, system component engineering, analysis modeling and the design engineering. On all these, you have to focus on while you are talking about the product. Okay, so this is very important for you can say to achieve the goal. Okay, now see the hierarchy of product engineering. In this you see product requirement engineering is further divided into system component engineering. These are the human engineering, hardware engineering, software engineering and the database engineering. Every engineering do its own work. This is basically concerned to this the human subjective, and this is regarding as the hardware, and this is regarding as the software, and this is for the database. Okay, so all these engineering basically focus on their area itself. Okay, so this can be called it as a system component engineering. Now further, if system engineering is divided, it is divided into functional, data and classes and the behavior. This we call it as a analysis modeling, because in this analysis mode, this comes into the category of software engineering. Okay, because you are working on the software. Okay, you are developing a software which software engineers develop. So if we are talking about this design modeling, means of course these whole analysis modeling is totally based on this. Design is totally based on this analysis modeling. Like data classes, you have to define architecture design, you have to mention their interface design and the component design. So these all comes into the category of the design modeling. Then further, design modeling is break into the constructions mode. After that, different you see here the boxes you can see, and they all work as per their work assigned. Okay, so this is a basically the product engineering hierarchy. So this is all about today's session. Thank you. This session powered by digital version 2.0, Jayoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.